Hey y'all, let's talk turkey. This is Nate with Victory Archery. I'm here with
Jayson Bensick, Victory Archery.
How you guys doing? So today we're going to talk about some different setups because what's right around the corner?
Turkey season.
Spring turkey season.
Gobble gobble.
I know a lot of guys out there have questions on their setup and what arrow is best for shooting turkey. At the end of the day, any arrow is great for shooting a turkey, but we've got some recommendations for you. Kind of try and help you out and guide you along and just give you a little input. Jason killed a lot of birds. I've killed quite a few birds. Idaho, Wyoming here, and growing up, that's what you did. I think we're going to go with the standard diameter setup here. So look at your V-Force arrow. I don't know, over 10 years ago you set up that deal with Magnus?
So Magnus broadheads with their bullhead actually packages just our inline V-Force Elite Series, the 001, with their Magnus bullhead in a three-pack. I believe it's a three-pack. Clamshelled, ready to go, full-length arrow, inserted, fletched, just basically...
300 spine on that one, if I'm not mistaken.
The 300 spine, yeah. So it's a stiffer spine, which you're going to need a stiffer spine for those bullheads because they are so large in diameter. There's a lot of surface area up there. And for the most part, too, you're going to need a tighter tolerance shaft. We all know we're shooting turkeys at, 10, 15, 20 yards for the most part, especially on a head lopper style.
That's what I was just going to say. So with that kind of setup, you're looking at like the bullhead. I think there's gobbler guillotines out there, but that's, you're going for lopping heads off of things.
Yeah, exactly. So 245 diameter tends to be the arrow diameter of choice with those types of broadheads. So you could either go our standard V-Force build, which we were just talking about, or our V-Force TKO in that TKO series. You're gonna wanna shoot those at full length as well. So a little bit tighter tolerance may be more in your wheelhouse for that type of broadhead, but that's definitely what I would recommend.
And the great thing about the TKO series, not that the V-Force isn't an extremely durable arrow, but the TKO, it just kind of adds a little bit on top of that. Recovers quick on shot, but either one of these two standard diameter arrows, full length for that head lopper style, and you're not going to go wrong.